When I first came into this lab, started to work with this carbon nanotube.
That's an important term to remember because carbon nanotubes are important to Dr. Wen-Ting Hsiao's work. During the pandemic, they were used to help detect COVID antigens.
There are specific receptors, like antibodies, that can specifically recognize the COVID antigens.
Fast forward 4 years later, the team here at Pitt seeks a new challenge, the drug epidemic.
That's why we wanted to use our technology to be able to detect these fentanyl, this little trace amount of fentanyl, in the mixture.
The synthetic opioid fentanyl, approximately 100 times more potent than morphine, is fueling overdose deaths in the country.
Fentanyl is now being mixed with other drugs to increase the potency of these drugs.
A modified version of the COVID sensor, this fentanyl sensor has a chip with those carbon nanotubes. Attached to those are nanoparticles with fentanyl antibodies.
In the middle, this is our sensor chip. And on the sensor chip, there are 8 sensors. So we functionalize fentanyl antibodies on the surface of our sensor so that our sensor can detect a trace amount of fentanyl. So it's gonna pick up the sample and then place it on the surface of the chip.
The research has already been published, showing the sensor was able to identify a fentanyl molecule. And it had a 91% success rate when it came to discerning fentanyl from other drugs, which could be useful if a drug may have been tainted with the deadly opioid.
It would be good for example, police to do some on-site detection if they encounter this unknown drug sample.
So just how small does the sample get? Well, the sensor, which is designed to be portable, can detect fentanyl on the femtomolar scale. That's 10 to 15 moles per liter, or in layman's terms, really, really, really small. Mike Valenti, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.